Let us see how to design a temple chhatri using 3ds Max. So let me create a base using the 2D shape, that is n-gon, and increase the number of sides to 8. Now selecting this, we shall apply modifier, that is extrude, and give some amount, that is the height, and create a copy holding shift key. Now next step is let us see how to create the column. So to create a column, we shall use the cylinder at one of the corner and increase the height. Adjust the radius and place it to the edge. Now let me create one more cylinder, that is I'll take a copy of it, and then apply taper and change the amount and the curve value to get a shape. Now using the 2D shape, that is circle, create a circle. And in the modifier, enable render, enable viewport to get the thickness in the radial form. We'll create the copy of the same 2D shape in Z direction. Using the line, we'll create a V surface, V shaped surface, and then apply extrude and then apply shell to give thickness and then move it to the required position. Create a box, rotate it, adjust the parameter, move it to the required area. Adjust the length to the V-shaped line. Now to create the design part, let us create a star using 2D shape. In the modifier, increase the points option and change the parameters, that is fillet radius 1 and 2 in some amount. In the modifier list, apply extrude. You can either apply extrude or you can apply slice to slice the area. If you slice it first, then you can apply extrude in the second part. If you extrude it first, then you can apply the slice next. Now to create the subtraction process, we will carry out the Boolean operation. Here this procedure doesn't work, so let me create the same situation again. That is, first you create a star, then apply the extrude and then slice it. Adjust it. Okay, now select the star which is extruded, and then apply, either you can apply slice, or see, if I don't apply slice, this is the thing, it will create a hollow in this part, but we want it in semicircle. So we shall slice it this way. But then again, here they are equal in length. Okay. Let us group it and change the pivot point to create the array. Increase the number of items. Now create the copy from the base. Now to make the dome part, next is making the dome part. Use the sphere and make it hemisphere. Now scale it accordingly. Now create a torus and align it using Shift A, so it aligns to the center. Now select the sphere and apply edit poly and select the edges and choose the loop option. so that it select in the form of a loop. So hold control and select the loop option. So it selects the loop altogether. So it becomes easy for us to extrude together. So I will not be selecting the entire sphere, the side which is visible. Only for that edge I will be choosing it. Now apply extrude, give amount of a height and a bit of width. Now apply chamfer to make it smooth. Increase a bit of segments to make it round shaped. Now to make the top part of the sphere, that is a dome, again I'll create a star, align it to the center and resize it. Apply extrude, also give the taper amount and the curve value to give the shape. Now the next part, what we want is the cone. Align it again. Now adjust the size by changing the radius 1, radius 2 and the height, and then apply the same edit poly modifier and give the same, choose the same parameters that is selecting the edges in the form of loop. And then applying extrude. And after applying extrude, we'll be giving the chamfer to make it smooth. So once after this, again we shall make use of the 2D shape, or we can also make use of torus to create the top part. Align it. Now move it above, adjust the size. Now above that again we shall increase the thickness or the radius 2. Again copy the same thing. I created a sphere, so just change in the shape. And now I'll create a capsule to make the top part. Reduce the height and the radius. If you want, apply the taper modifier. To give a shape. Yeah, done. And now we'll apply the material, that is the Ernold material. I'll be applying one single material, that is a physical material. Just select it, assign one single material. I'll give one marble texture. Okay. So in the surfaces where the material is not shown, you can select it and you can generate, enable the generate mapping coordinates. because we have made use of 2D shape. So when we create a 2D shape and start applying material, it will not be visible on screen as well as in the rendering. So we can use this option, or you can also use the option UVW map in the modifier list. Now I'm started applying the lights. Just the free lights I'm applying. And then once applied the lights, just set the page for rendering and then render it. So it is little brighter. You can change the intensity, but it has taken the same shape. So that is about Temple Chhatri. Thank you for watching.